Finbar Coghlan works on the development of new wind farms for energy-generating company Centrica. The decision where and when to build a new farm is an extremely complex one, requiring very detailed analyses, as he explains in this video clip.
As part of the development team, we have to do all manner of surveys, everything from geophysical site surveys, geotechnical investigation, monitoring ship movements across the Irish Sea, liaise with fisheries and local commerce that use the sea for their business. We also have to look at the environmental impacts, so this can range from everything from birds right down to marine mammals, fish species, benthic communities on the seabed. We go offshore, we measure wind strengths, we determine mean wind speeds, mean wind directions. We have to come up with a financial decision at the end of the day whether a project is economic or not.
The process to actually get the financial approval from the company to go ahead and build the project involves huge analysis work with a series of interlinked spreadsheets, looking at the costs of building, looking at the revenue that's going to come from the park, and taking into account the discounted cash flow and tax analysis. Quite a complicated set of calculations designed to ensure that the projects are actually profitable.
And this is a balance between capital expenditure that goes into a project and the anticipated revenue that we will generate from a project. If the two aren't in harmony, we will not develop the project. A fundamental equation to the wind industry is the energy yield per unit time, typically a year. Here we see that energy yield is equal to RC times LF times A, multiplied by the number of hours in a year. RC stands for rated capacity of the wind farm, typically in megawatts. LF is load factor. This accounts for the fact that the wind doesn't blow all the time, and hence we have a factor of less than one. A is for availability. This accounts for things such as reliability of the wind turbines and the time to repair the turbines. So hence, in a full year, we won't have 100% availability due to mechanical failures, etc. If we put this into an example here, we have a wind farm with a rated capacity of 300 megawatts, a load factor of 0.4, and an availability of 0.95. The load factor and availability just mentioned are typical values for offshore wind farms. When you put this into the equation, we come out with a figure of 998,640 megawatt hours per year. So putting this figure into economic terms, we take the 998,640 megawatt hours per year, times it by the wholesale price of electricity at that point in time, and we come up with a revenue generated from the wind farm. In this case, £39,945,600. In this example, we see that we come to a revenue figure of just under £40 million for 1 year. This has to be extrapolated over the lifetime of a project, which is typically 25 years. And this determines whether the project will be viable or not.